And they should never let y'all go nowhere by yourself.
I don't know.
Just y'all two?
We do what we can.
Y'all be putting together crazy then.
We're live.
Oh, we're live?
Yeah. We're in New York City. I don't know why I brought this person with me. I definitely should have left her the hell at home.
I'm the blessings of the Bureau Bully. Thank you. When I come, blessings come.
Anywho, back on the star. We are here in New York. Shayk Mahi is the keynote speaker. I'm really looking forward to that. It's been a very long time since I went to an event and looked forward to somebody else speaking. So I think since Sophia shares in the excitement, I'm really excited about hearing Shayk Mahi. We're here to commemorate the great Shayk Hassan Cisse, one of my heroes, a legend who changed many lives. We can go on and on and on about stories about Shayk Hassan. But I'm excited, I'm grateful, and I'm humbled to be here. Chris got my brother Chris. Nobody else is allowed to shoot. I just tell him, press the button and keep the camera running. Whatever happens, happens. But anywho, we're here. And this is the first I Love Myself vlog. Unfortunately, she'll be here. And I'm looking at embarrassing pictures now to put up with her on Instagram.
If you post it, we're going to be praying Janaz a prayer. Look it up.
I don't mind dying.
I'm grateful that the chefs value a woman's place in the song. I'm here for Billy John T. I don't know why they put him on the stage, because that's like ghetto, but you know, it's ghetto here, so I'm talking about here in this world. But yeah, I'm excited. I'm blessed to be here.
Let's see, which one are we going to use? I'm good, Jeep. Good to see you. How's the family?
Beautiful.
How are you?
Good. How are you? Welcome.
Jeep, you on the I Love Myself vlog, so tell them where we at.
I love myself, first of all. And second of all, we at the 11th annual Shayk Hassan Cisse Ziyarah. If you don't know who Shayk Hassan is, go Google him, and you can find that out. But right now, I'm with my brother Umar, who's about to tear it down and let y'all know what the business is.
Let's go.
Inshallah, Allah cleanse our hearts.
I mean.
And make us be brothers
in
this life and in the next.
I mean.
Peace.
Thank you, G. Zakia, say hi to the camera. That's my niece, y'all. Unfortunately, they claim she came from this. I don't have the proof to back that up, but I was looking at this, and people always ask me, when they ask about the Bureau Boys, they always say, what was my favorite part? Was it meeting people? Was it all the settlements? And to be honest, my favorite part was not the settlements. It was that people stopped settling. They stopped settling for poverty. They stopped settling for less. They stop settling for anything less than self-love. That's my favorite part of the Bureau Bullies. Chris likes that. I don't think people here know how big of a deal he is. But I would say, like, he literally changed the trajectory of Black America in America. He went out of his way to come here to help people. And he did that on every level, spiritually, financially, every single level. There's so many stories. You're going to hear them all tonight. There's like, I mean, it's... If I were to sit here and try to figure out every story, it'd be really hard. But yeah, a million and one stories. It's something I've been hearing about since I was a kid.
Oh, we like how you guys did this.
That was your doing, wasn't it, G?
You know, I got a little
smack.
Not much, but you know.
That's tough, right? This is hard, G. What you been up to, though, bro?
Just working.
What you got going on now?
It's infinite purpose. So, I'm building in the background right now, but I want to get away from the stuff that's money based.
Or. Because anybody show you how to get money, but anybody show you how to get purpose. Or. No,
that's real,
bro. That's heavy.
Heavy.
All right, y'all. So we're about less than an hour away from me speaking, and I have no idea what I'm going to talk about. I had over a month to prepare for this, and I didn't write anything. But you just...
You got to read the room, and then it's going to talk.
You just got to let spirit guide you. The spirit. Okay, we ain't doing all that bullshit. You got to let Allah guide you. Every single speech I've given, I've never thought about it. Chris recorded every one. I freestyled every single one. I'm a little more nervous about this one just because of the magnitude of the person who this event is about. But we can still do it. You want to come on the podcast real quick?
No problem.
Okay, we come over here. So we're live. We're here at the commemoration for the great Shayk Hassan Cisse. And we're here with my brother.
Imam Ibrahim Niyas.
Imam Ibrahim Niyas. Imam Ibrahim Niyas. It's alhamdulillah. So what we do on the podcast is we try to encourage self-love. And so what we do is we get random people to give three reasons why they love themselves. So you can tell the people three reasons why you love yourself.
Love, shirk. Love who?
And why you love you.
Myself.
Uh-huh.
Alhamdulillah. We're supposed to be love each other.
Mm.
He said, human being, we're supposed to be respect each other.
Mm.
So that's why I love you. I love my brother. I love my sister.
La ilaha
that's
Allah.
In Islam.
La ilaha illallah.
We say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. So we are one. Hambrilla one, drinking one water, one everything.
Mm.
So that's the only thing maybe I can
say. Thank you. Oh, yeah, bro.
We in New York City, alhamdulillah, at the 11th commemoration and beautiful service for Shayk Hassan Cisse, where we're going to be talking about his life and all the work that we continue to do in his name through Nasr Al America.
And we're here with my brother who?
Muhammad Detroit.
That's what we all know him as, Muhammad Detroit. Now, bro, here on the I Love Myself podcast, we encourage self-love, so we need you to give three reasons why you love yourself.
Well, for sure, I love you more than I love myself. And the reason why I say that is because we can't truly be Muslim if we don't love for our brother what we love for ourselves.
Mm.
And by you having a podcast called I Love Myself, it's showing that you want to show people what's important about themselves.
Mm.
If I don't see myself as you and you don't see myself as me, then sometimes we become divided.
Mm.
And our hearts are one. So alhamdulillah, I'm glad you love me and I love you.
Yeah, I love you too, bro.
Alhamdulillah.
Thank you. Who am I here with?
Ayana, definitely one of your bureau bullies.
All right.
Taking my time and learning the information that you're giving.
Let's go.
And let's make those changes. Let's make it happen.
So here on the I Love Myself podcast, we encourage self-love. Give me three reasons why you love yourself.
I'm unique. I'm special. And I'm the consumer, and I have all the power.
Let's go. I like that, Chris. You know, here we encourage self-love. Give us three reasons why nobody likes you. I'm playing. Give us three reasons why you love yourself.
Three reasons why I love myself. I love myself because I'm unique. There's nobody like me. The Most High literally crafted me in a very unique image. Give me the microphone because you're trying to hate. I'm the cool mom. I'm the cool auntie. Everybody loves me. All praise is due to the Most High. Parents did an excellent job of instilling Islam in me. That is the single most thing that I am most grateful for. So I love that they gifted me with that. That's a legacy that I cherish and I hope to carry on for a lifetime. May Allah make it so. And I love me because I'm stylish. Like, who does it? He's such a hater. He's such a hater. Listen, y'all get in his DMs and say, be nice to Sister Sophia. Say that.
Yeah, y'all, if y'all believe that.
I love myself.
If y'all actually believe anything she said.
And I love y'all.
If y'all actually believe anything she said. Hold on, Chris. Make sure you get the fit first.
Make sure these are gum bottles. These ain't just regular white on white. These are gum bottles.
All right, so we live with my good brother, Shayk Hassan.
Let's go.
And you on the I Love Myself podcast. Here on the I Love Myself podcast, we encourage self-love. So you got to give us three reasons why you love yourself.
Oh, man, I love myself because I'm God-fearing. I love myself because I'm blessed. I love myself because my future looks bright.
Let's go, my brother. Thank you.
I appreciate you, brother.
Appreciate you, bro. Thank you.
You already know.
All right, y'all. So we're back. We're here with my good brother, Brother Kamal. And here on the I Love Myself podcast, we encourage self-love. So I need you to give us three reasons why you love yourself.
I love myself because my creator created me, number one. I love myself because I'm from the Ummah of Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm created from his nur, his light, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So how could I not love myself? If I love the messenger, I can't not love myself. And then third, Allah honored the children of Adam. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Allah said, I honor deeply the children of Adam. Adam. So how can I not love what Allah honored from being from Bani Adam, from human beings? So may Allah grant us all, may the Creator grant us all the supreme love, love supreme, from His presence to know His love intimately. Thank you.
Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you. Assalamualaikum. Does everybody here know what I do? Does anybody know who I am? No? Okay. Well, this is actually my first introduction to our community, so I'm really excited about that. This is like a surreal moment. When Ajib introduced this to me a while ago, he said he wanted me to come speak, and I had to check my phone to make sure he was talking to the right Umar. I was certain he called the wrong person. Then the second time he called me, I just had to say, Jeeb, if y'all need a janitor, just tell me. I'll come clean up, if that's what you need me to do. But about back in July, all this is, you know, I talk in circles, I know y'all don't know me. Let me start here. I have a mantra that we came up with. When I was traveling around and working, what I noticed was missing most from our people was self-love. So it's almost impossible to teach somebody to love someone else if they don't love themselves. Because it's impossible to give something you have not given yourself. You ever tried to give a dollar when you don't have a dollar? So we came up with a mantra. It's called I Love Myself. And so before we do any courses or any classes or any tours, we make everybody in the room say they love themselves. So y'all ready to do it? I love myself. I love myself. I love myself. I didn't make that up. It's actually something that I needed at a certain point in my life. There's a quote from Rumi. If you say this in the wrong parts of Philly, you'll get canceled. But I think all of us in this room, we know what this means. He said, in order to know Allah, you have to become Allah. Does that make sense? Everybody understand that? So I'm going to introduce y'all to the work that we do. We started out just teaching people how to do credit. But what I realized was everybody on Instagram was teaching that, so they weren't coming to us to learn credit. A friend of mine, his entire family took Shahada because of Shayk Hassan. And listen to how Shayk Hassan introduced Islam to them. He came to a public school and spoke, and I had to ask Jeeb about the story, and Jeeb was with him at that particular school. It's a public school in Atlanta. And he went to the school, and this kid said, I want to drop out of school. Shayk Hassan said, you want to leave school? There's a book you can learn, and you can live over in Africa. You all know what that book was? Does anybody know what that book was? The Quran. And so Shayk Hassan said this to the little boy, and he went to his family and told him. The entire family came to Shayk Hassan and took Shahada. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. So what I learned from that was that we have to give people what they want and raise them with what they need. People want love. Do y'all agree? But they can't give it because they've never been taught how to give it to themselves first. So that's why I found my lane. That's why Allah gave me my lane. You're not just gonna use credit, we're gonna teach self-love. So back in July, to tell you how surreal this moment was, because when Jeeb first presented this to me, I didn't think I fit in. When I looked at just a stage with Sheikh Mahi alone, I shouldn't have been on that stage. But when Ajib first introduced this to me, I didn't think I fit in. And about a month later, well, around that time, I wanted to give up on the work I was doing. I had lost the love for it. And in that same month, in the month of July, I suffered a heart attack. The enzymes, there's people there, medical professionals here say, no, I can't make that up. But the enzymes in my heart had went up way too high. And I was experiencing severe chest pain. So I went to the hospital and they made me stay. Now, they got the enzymes down, but the chest pain wouldn't go away.
So they gave me oxycodone, the good stuff. And I fell asleep. And I'm probably not supposed to do this, but I don't always follow all the rules. But I've only told a few people this dream. In the dream, Shayk Hassan was there. And he didn't speak much, but he pointed. And we were in the desert. It looked like Sudan, if you ask me. And we were in the desert, and he pointed, and Shayk Ibrahim Niass was there. I couldn't understand what he was saying, but he told us to follow him, and we walked through the desert, and I woke up. Now, you know, you have a dream like that, you got to send that right over to Africa right away. And so when the dream was interpreted, he said, you have a big mission or a big dream, and Shayk Ibrahim Niass is going to help you with that. And what my mission has become has not been, you know, we've beaten up on Experian, TransUnion, and Equifax enough. If you go to our Instagram, the Bureau Bullets, you'll see all of our followers have gotten settlements. But that wasn't my real mission. My real mission comes from a quote from Sayyidina Ali. He says, and I kind of cut it short because I'm running short on time. He said, if poverty was a man, I'd bring death to him. Because if you look at what the condition of poverty does to our people, right? If you look in the inner cities in America, how hard is it for some of them to practice Islam just based on their condition? You got to work 60 to 80 hours a week, right? But my new mission, you know, we were called the Bureau Bullies. My new mission is to bully poverty. And we can't do that alone because I'm not just talking about financial poverty. I'm talking about spiritual poverty, which is why we're all here. Talking about myself first. So this has been the mission, and this is what we're working towards. And I hope that all of you will work with us. I'm really at a loss for words because I don't think y'all know how much this moment means to me to even be on this stage. I remember years ago when we had one in Atlanta, and I don't know what I was thinking when I walked in and said this to myself, but I walked in, and for some reason, in my head, I said, I'm going to speak at a Shayk Hassan event one day. And it happened. And so what I tell people from that is not only are the words you say a prayer, but the things you say to yourself in your mind, you're still praying. You never know who or what is saying that means, so be very careful about what you say to yourself. I know I'm all over the place, but I'm just really excited. Ajib reminded me before I came up here that we're here to raise money for the African American Islamic Institute. We've all benefited from Shayk Hassan in one way or another, whether we know it or not, whether we can see it or not. So I think it's only right that we dig in our pocket and we continue to invest. I mean, just a 20-year-old Hafiz, how insane is that? How real is that, right? So I think we have an obligation, all of us, to continue to invest in that. And as we continue to, you know, the more that we give, the more we'll get, especially to the right causes. So I had to mention, Brother G made that clear, I had to mention that. And I think that's ultra important. But I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. I want to thank my brother G for this opportunity. Thank my brother Van for the opportunity. Peace and love to you all, and thank you all. As-salamu alaykum.